because you are gospel to a way of life, and it's no longer that way of life is there.
Simplemente septiembre fueron muchos meses que tuvimos sin energía eléctrica, sin agua potable, muchos sin techo, y hoy en día podemos decir que sobrevivimos a María.
On September 20th, 2017, a Category 4 hurricane came and devastated the island of Puerto Rico. But as when Maria left, the people felt abandoned. The storm's heavy rain, violent winds, catastrophic flooding, and landslides shattered the island's infrastructure and further weakened its economy. It was the worst recorded natural disaster for this region and America's worst blackout, lasting many months. It sparked the largest immigration from the island since 1950 and further contributed to the closure of 265 schools. The distribution of aid was inadequate and chaotic, leaving some American citizens living in barely a skeleton of what was once their home for generations. When the government was exposed for covering up supplies left to rot in containers, for embezzling funds meant for reconstruction, and for ridiculing the people it swore to serve, up to 1 million fed-up Puerto Ricans took to the streets of San Juan to overthrow their governor. I can think of at least 4,645 reasons why we can't let what happened with Hurricane Maria be lost in history. The lives lost rival the collapse of the World Trade Center and Hurricane Katrina combined. This is why the story needs to be told, but it's not my story to tell. I put my business on hold in New York, and with my brother, traveled to all 78 pueblos, including places the media, aid, and outside recovery simply never came. These are the voices of local Boricuas who responded and survived. We heard their strength, their courageousness, and their orgullo. Las ganas de echar pa'lante. Directly from the true heroes of the island, the Boricuas who are raising Puerto Rico back up by its roots.
Este golpe de María nos unió.
¿Por qué? El Boricua no se cae.